we want to see Durlin, I'm certain the tavern is our stop. Symbol of their betrayal, their cruelty personified. The sooner we are done with it, the better.
If I can make peace with my blades.
I suppose you're right. If Skofnung rids the land of these bastards, I can stomach its presence a bit longer.
Do you regret it, Mimir?
Most likely. What are we talking about in particular?
Giving up your body?
Do I regret exchanging my life for my freedom? That's a question I ask myself every day, my lady.
What about today?
Today? Glad to be out in the world. How else could I spend such quality time with you?
Okay.
Brother, can we finish what you were saying about the Oracle of your homeland? She had visions of the God of War causing Olympus to fall.
Yes. She assumed that to mean Ares, so she aided me against him. She did not foresee that I would kill him and take his office. In the end, I proved her vision of doom correct.
So the Oracle herself brought about the very future she hoped to avoid. I'm so very relieved we didn't do the same.
There's another of Garm's realm tears nearby. Alasa! Kratos.
Follow me.
Brother, I've been meaning to ask. Your homeland. I'd heard the gods there wielded every flavor of power you could imagine. Lightning, fire, the whole lot.
As did I, for many years.
Whoa. Any chance you could recall some of that magic?
No. I have tried.
Magic is bound to the Earth. When your homeland died, your powers probably went with it.
Ah. Well, probably for the best. Let the past stay in the past and all that. Just curious, brother. Why don't you like riddles?
They are frivolous.
They encourage lateral thinking. Listen. There are three doors before you. One contains a pit of spikes, one a dragon, and one a pair of lions that haven't been fed in weeks. Which door do you open?
The first. Pit of spikes is easily avoided.
Ah, you should pick the third, because lions that haven't been fed in weeks would be dead! Eh?
I like this riddle.
I preferable to silence at last? A rare day. I'm touched. But since you mention it, there has been one on my mind of late. It goes back to my earliest days, when I had little more to do than observe the mortals who passed through our forest. One summer, a local laird of renowned eccentricity chose to sequester himself with a small coterie of kinsmen and followers. And time to walk. The story will keep. Brother, I've heard my share of stories about your homeland. But I'd also heard that you once fought in a tournament.
I fought in many contests.
But this particular one, I heard you did battle with beasts, scoundrels, princesses, the undead, automatons, and history's greatest musician. That's not true, is it?
I would not speak of this.
Fair enough, brother. Okay, my story. Where was I? Oh! The eccentric laird had led his followers in a woodland retreat with an aim of achieving enlightenment through study and discipline.
Hold. We will finish later.
Still trouble here?
Careful, brother. You're covered in black god. Incoming! Above you!
Another camp defeated.
Aye, and one step closer to giving the realms a shot at healing. Learn anything?
Kratos, tell me of an adversary from your homeland. It will serve us well if I understand more of your battle tactics.
There was Medusa, Queen of the Gorgons. Her gaze turned men to stone. A mirror would turn her own powers against her. Or, you may remove her head, but that is the hard way.
Which did you choose?
The hard way.
Forget I asked.
Getting back to my story then, if I may. The Enlightenment-seeking Laird and his followers took oaths to brook no distractions until they became wise men.
Distractions?
Aye. Women. Drink. Mostly women. As you can imagine, things deteriorated quickly. By autumn, tempers were frayed and wisdom remained in short supply. One day, I watched as the Laird and his brother took their hunt. There they found, at the banks of a river, a lady as fair as any they'd left behind. She pleads for their assistance for fear the currents would carry her off if she tried to cross. The Laird doesn't miss a beat. He hoists her onto his shoulders, carries her across, sets her down, doffs his cap, and fords back across to his brother, who is dumbfounded, can't even bring himself to speak. The day stretches on, the Laird carries on hunting, and his brother quietly gnashes his teeth down to powder. Finally, the dam breaks. Brother, he cries, how could you do it after everything we've sacrificed? How could you break your vow like it was nothing, carrying that lass on your shoulders like you were a Shetland pony? The Laird just smiles. Brother, I set that lass down across the river. 'Tis you that carries her still. Oh, I got a chuckle. A rare day indeed.
Why do you yawn?
Force of habit, I suppose, since I don't sleep anymore. Although, it's far more confounding that I'm the tired one. I've seen you stay awake for days at a time without so much as a drooping eyelid. Not even a nap.
Gods do not nap.
Oh, tell that to Thor.
Why do you yawn?
Force of habit, I suppose, since I don't sleep anymore. Although, it's far more confounding that I'm the tired one. I've seen you stay awake for days at a time without so much as a drooping eyelid. Not even a nap.
Gods do not nap.
Oh, tell that to Thor.
Go!
Lunda.
Hi there. I wanted to ask, do you want me to stop talking about your muscles and how you look and stuff? Because it seems like it's making you all wiggly, like in a bad way.
It did, but no longer.
Oh, okay. So I should stop? Sounds like I should stop.
No.
Oh, all right, handsome. You beefcake? Just when I thought you couldn't get more godly. What do you need, handsome?
Look, over there. to the crater, then.
There are still a few loose ends to tie up. We found some wayward spirits in the crater. Think they might know something about what happened there? And what else?
Something big and hungry stalks the jungle within the crater. Perhaps we could look into it.
Also what?
Say their warriors still haunt the crater. We could put them to rest.
I'm with you.